From Pune, this is Adventist World Radio.
Hello and welcome to our International English Service.
On our broadcast today, we have music from heritage singers and celestial singers.
A nature study on smooth stones.
We shall end our program with a message from God's Word on the topic, Never Give Up, Be Strong in the Lord. This is your host, Sharad.
I'm Maureen and you are listening to Adventist World Radio, The Voice of Hope.
Let's begin our program with a song entitled, Lord, I'm Coming Home.
You just heard a song by the Heritage Singers on Adventist World Radio, The Voice of Hope from Pune, India. And now a nature study will be brought to you by Nilima on smooth stones.
Hello friends, our study today is on smooth stones. Is there a boy who hasn't gone to the water's edge of a small stream, picked up a smooth stone and tried to skip it across the water? For years, as I have approached a body of water, I have wanted to pick up smooth stones and skip them across the water. It is still fun to see how many times I can skip the stone on top of the water. Have you ever wondered what made stones smooth? A rock hound, that is, a person who collects and polishes rocks will pick up the ugliest rock, put them in a tumbler, and after some time, take them out all smooth. What has happened? As the rock rolls in the tumbler, all of the sharp edges are worn off and the rock becomes smooth. A stream of water, or small river, or even the waves at the edge of the ocean keep rolling the rocks, and over a period of time they become smooth. All of the sharp edges are worn off and the rocks become nice, smooth stones. They are not made smooth in a day, but over a long period of time. Nature's forces are often slow, but because they are steady, they have been able to move mountains, carve new riverbeds, and create underground caverns. We as sinners have rough edges caused by sin in our lives. The Lord wants us to have all our roughness removed, so He allows us to go through trials that will help wear down the rough edges and make us a smooth and valuable stone. Dear listeners, as we meet obstacles in our lives and conquer them, roughness is worn off. As we steadily meet trials and conquer them, our character is polished. God does not promise us a smooth life altogether, but He does promise to be with us and help us through the trials. Ask God today to be with you as you go through the day. As the trials come, with His help, you will be able to meet and overcome them.
Thank you, Nilima, for sharing a nature study on smooth stones on AWR.
To learn more on God's Word, you are welcome to write to us. Here is our mailing address.
Adventist World Radio, Post Box Number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
You could also email us on AdventistMediaCenter@gmail.com.
Before you hear God's Word, here's another song entitled, "The Lord is My Shepherd."
Come and feed us,
You are listening to Adventist World Radio, the voice of hope from Pune, India. Dear friends, the Bible in the book of Psalms, chapter 46, verse 1 says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Just like the hurricanes, the storms of our lives arrive with unnerving regularity. Often they strike without warning and linger without welcome, testing the limits of our faith and endurance. But God has given us a place of safety in the midst of our circumstances.
The prophet Nahum wrote, "The Lord is good, a stronghold in the way of trouble. Therefore we will not fear, even though the earth be removed."
God Himself is our center of safety. It is not our strength, but His that shields us from the whirling winds of circumstances and change. So, dear listener, never give up. Be strong in the Lord. Time to
dear
hear
listener,
God's word.
The story is told about a young man who decided to travel around the world in a small boat that he built for himself. A large crowd gathered on the shore to see him off. Many in the crowd were actively discouraging this ambitious young man. However, in the midst of all the discouraging warnings, there was one who could not resist offering some optimistic words. As the little craft began its journey, he shouted at the top of his voice, "Bon voyage! You are really someone great. We are proud of you. God be with you." Dear listener, our thought is taken from the verse that is taken from the Bible, and that is found in Luke chapter 5 verse 11. And here it says, "And when they had brought their ships to the land, they forsook all and followed him." Dear listener, just imagine what would have happened if the disciples had decided to give up and return to the shore without trying once more, as Jesus had asked them to do. Not only could they have missed the greatest catch ever, but they would have failed to recognize Jesus as the Messiah. Satan is exultant when he can lead the children of God into unbelief and despondency. He delights to see us mistrusting God, doubting His willingness and power to save us. Are you captured and consumed by a vision, but you feel paralyzed by the fear of the unknown dangers that you may encounter in pursuit of your vision? A substantial percentage of people fail to see beyond the danger, and their visions remain but a vision. However, history is full of people who refuse to give up. Edison didn't give up on the light bulb. Luther refused to back down from his goal. Lincoln refused to give up no matter how many times he failed. Dear listener, we often encounter people who are in their little boats setting forth in the ocean for enormous possibilities. Do we discourage them or comfort them with our words of support? Dare to urge them? Dare to shout, "Never give up"? Not only must we not give up, but we must build our own little boats and set out on our own quests and voyages. Dear listener, how can we experience God's strength in our life? Let's look into the Bible and the book of Nehemiah, chapter 8, verse 10. Here it says, "Nehemiah continued, 'Go and celebrate with a feast of choice foods and sweet drinks, and share gifts of food with people who have nothing prepared.'" This is a sacred day before the Lord. Don't be dejected and sad, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Dear listener, strength starts in the heart long before it is exerted in other aspects of life. The joy of the Lord gives us strength to obey, to endure, and to triumph in all circumstances. Isaiah chapter 40 verses 29 and 31 says, "He gives power to those who are tired and worn out. He offers strength to the weak. Those who wait on the Lord will find new strength. They will fly high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. Dear listener, life wears us out, but waiting on the Lord renews our strength. Our limitations remind us to rely more fully on the Lord. What can we do in God's strength? Let's again look into the Bible, and this time in the book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 13. And it says, I can do everything with the help of Christ who gives me the strength I need. There are no limits, dear listeners, to what God can do in and through us. Psalms 18 verses 1 and 2, 29 and 30 says, I love you, Lord. You are my strength. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my Savior. My God is my rock and in whom I find protection. He is my shield, the strength of my salvation and my stronghold. In your strength, I can crush an army. With my God, I can scale any wall. As for God, His ways is perfect. All the Lord's promises prove true. He is a shield for all who look to Him for protection. Dear listener, God's strength in us is a result of His love for us. In His strength, we have the power to do things that we could never do on our own. We can withstand the toughest attacks and can take the offensive to overcome our problems. By God's strength, we can live without fear, because God's strength drives out fear. Let us glorify God with the promises that He has given in the Bible for each one of us. Dear listener, let me conclude by giving a small illustration on strength. A large company uses suction to extract contaminating substances from steel drums. Powerful pumps draw the materials out of the barrels, but the workers must carefully regulate the force of these pumps. If they take out too much air, the drums will collapse like paper cups, because the outer pressure will exceed the inner pressure. Likewise, when adversity and hardships come into our lives, God must empower us from within, or we will be unable to withstand the pressure from without. True, we get solid support from our loved ones and good friends, but it is our spiritual inner man, strengthened with might through His Spirit, that sustains us and keeps us from crumbling. The Holy Spirit works to strengthen us and to renew our minds as we read the Bible and pray. If we neglect the Scriptures, seldom talk with the Lord, and stop fellowshipping with other believers, we'll grow weak and vulnerable. Then we will be unable to withstand the pressures of temptation or trouble. Dear listener, let's ask the Lord to develop our inner strength so that when life's blows and burdens press upon us, we will not give in. With this shall we all pray. Our loving God, God of our strength in weakness, may we be strengthened through Thy Holy Spirit to overcome evil with good and not give up, but be strong in the Lord. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen.
Dear listener, trust you enjoyed our program. The Bible in Isaiah chapter 40 verse 29 says, He gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, He increases strength.
We need God's power even more when we go through the periods of emptiness, depression, or testing. Feeling shut down, we cry out to God. Isaiah declared that the Lord gives power to the weak and increases strength. We need the strength of the Lord not only for the severe trials, but also for everyday living. And He has promised it. When we turn to God, we can mount up with wings like eagles.
When trouble blows into your life, seek shelter in God.
There's a gentle breeze that's blowing by the river, and it brings a calm assurance to my soul. As I feel your presence come to rest beside me, Spirit, come to cleanse and make me whole. I hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees above, as I stand in awe of nature's wondrous scene. And Lord, I've come to understand the purpose of your master plan, and what all of your creation was to me. By that river, Lord, I hear you speak to me. In the leaves that rustle on the lofty, your gentle touch is all it takes to strengthen me. By that river, Lord, is where I wanna be. I remember, Lord, your on Calvary, how you proved your love and did it all for me. How you bore the thorns, nails and scorns with dignity, oh, just to save a sinful wretch like me. By that river, Lord, I wanna be forever
singing
praises to the Lamb who set me free. And Lord, I know if I can make it to that river with you, my God, on the lofty trees. Oh, your gentle touch is all it takes to strengthen me. By that river, Lord, is where I wanna be. Thank you.
With this, we have almost come to the end of our program. To learn more on God's Word and His love and strength, do write to us on
Adventist World Radio, Post Box number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
That's Adventist World Radio, Post Box number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
You could also email us on AdventistMediaCenter@gmail.com.
You could also follow us on our website, awr.org/English program. This is your host, Sharad.
And I'm Maureen, signing off from Adventist World Radio.
Do join us again along with your family and friends.
Until we meet via radio again, take care and goodbye.
And God bless you.